Alrighty, everybody. Thank you again for joining us this week. Today, we're continuing on Pepe. Phantasy Star Online 2, Fight for All. The Fight for All Fate. The Fight for the Fate of All. Sorry, that shouldn't have been that hard. Alright, let's continue on.
You did well defeating Verona and deploying the barrier. It's a shame Harriet had to stay on Omega to keep the barrier running.
Oh well.
She was probably right about the barrier not being as dramatic a success as it was on Harukotan. Plus, Huey's reports from the front suggest we're not putting up much of a fight. We're badly outgunned.
We've been stuck in tactical retreat mode all this time, though. Any win we can achieve would be a breath of fresh air.
Since the barrier went up, Shiva's been pulling back her forces and amassing them around the mothership.
She's practically daring us to attack, but she can just keep on churning out more forces, so we can't just leave her be.
Exactly. All that's left is an all-out do-or-die battle. One last fight.
Do and probably die.
For Earth, for Omega, for all of existence. Send the order to gather as soon as we're ready. Until then, everyone, keep your spirit.
Risa's instability. How you doing? Feeling lonely? Take that, Grinder, thank you. Across the distance. Dun dun dun.
It does pain me greatly to know that I may in fact fall before I can make good on my vow to you. But if that must be, it must be. We old soldiers are here to pave the way to a brighter future, even if we are not meant to see it. I only hope you are able to see for yourself the future that we build. Consider that very last request of this feckless old man who couldn't even manage to deliver on one promise.
kind of ignored this whole conversation. The officer's wish. At least tell Regius what she said. Come on.
Report duly received. The results are unfortunate, but there's nothing I can do. Take some time to recuperate.
Man, I want to go out there and fight.
Hello there. Got something on your mind?
What's with him?
I just got a report regarding their mission, and unfortunately, the results are less than ideal. They managed to avoid complete extermination, but that may have been their only real success to speak of. When you're sent to the battlefield, there is always the chance something could go awry. You could get injured.
Yes, Flufferbutt. See what mommy's doing? Huh?
I know that they have accepted the risk.
Okay, you can lay in my lap. That's fine. No. Could have just gone straight to the window. Why would you do that, huh?
You're absolutely right. Of course. I understand that everyone knows exactly what they signed up for.
Wait, good girl. You good girl, Regan.
Even if an order makes sense when it's issued, hindsight being 2020, means that you sometimes realize there were better options available. Though it pains me to think of those who were hurt, that constant reanalysis is key to devising
less
costly strategies going forward. Ultimately, what we want to achieve is the best survival rate possible for our operatives. Their well-being means everything to me. I'm sorry to always ask so much of you, Guardians. Yeah. This will be the most challenging mission you have faced yet. Please make sure that you come back in one piece. That's not
an order.
It's my personal wish as an officer. As someone who has
known you since you joined the base. No, off the keyboard. Yeah. I'll take that tri-boost, thank you. Vacation, save the world. Let me move. That way you can cuddle down on Mama.
That's right. It's kind of imprudent to think about recreation when the hour of the final battle draws near. Hey, what's the problem with some kickback? We're all gonna need to get some rest and relaxation if we really want to bring our A-game to the final battle.
Good girl. Hey, watch those claws, okay? My pants can only protect so much. Oh, ow, 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 ow. Let go. Alright. Ow! Watch those claws. There we go.
Coming too, right?
What are you talking about?
Azunami here just invited us to go on vacation for some R&R. At first, I thought it was a completely crazy idea. But she's right. This is exactly the time to be getting some rest. Now that that's settled, the best spot for a vacation has to be the beach, right?
Yeah, she's very shy. Something cute for these two.
Can you stop with the teasing already? I really don't think cute swimwear is my kind of thing. I don't think I'm good enough to wear something super cutesy. It'd be such a mismatch and so embarrassing.
It doesn't have to be sexy. It just has to be cute.
The coming battle is going to be an uphill struggle, so everyone's really high strung. No doubt some think resting is out of the question. But me? I disagree. There's a time to rest and a time to give it your all. Personally, I believe in the healing power of R&R. In any case, being able to go have some fun with you is no doubt what those two are most happy about. So don't go doing anything reckless. We're all looking forward to letting loose with you. Don't disappoint me now.
One minus one and one plus one. Yeah, I'm gonna go in the window. Alright.
You bet! This might be a little sudden, but I've got a question for our two guardians.
Of course they want to talk.
What strategy will our two guardians implement into their next battle? Question one? Hey, I thought you said you were. Shiva, even if it costs us our lives, or B, we're coming home in one piece. If you pick option A, then even if I have to die here.
Shut up.
What's wrong? Well, I was going to say that even if I have to die here, I won't let you go. Isn't sacrifice a noble thing?
Yeah, but it's still not the best way to go about shit. If you can survive and do it, then do that.
Why did you just change your mind so quickly? When facing a strong enemy, you have to give it everything you've got. And when that moment comes, I've got you on lock. Can you dig it? Unbelievable. How about this, Patty? What's one minus one? Hey, don't treat me like an idiot.
Yeah, Patty, you're an idiot.
What I'm trying to say is that even if you achieve your goal, if someone can't. Okay, then here's a practical question. What if you achieve your goal and the person you care about comes back to life? Then the question becomes. Yes, good job!
We're coming home in one piece. So you would defame a dead person.
Huh? What? No way. What dirt could you possibly have on me? Could she be talking about that one time? Or was it that time when I... Careful, Matoy. Don't fall for Patty's cheap tricks to make you spill the beans.
I'll take that other try boost. Thank you. Obsessed with the newlywed life. Dun dun dun. Oh yeah, that's right. Those two got married, didn't they?
I would be grateful if you could give me some tips for the future. Oh, that's a tough one. Hey, Hulk, are you the one who egged Io on? My reputation precedes me. I'm just saying, Io's also interested. And your life is a newlywed. So that's why she said she wanted to sit down and talk over coffee then. Oh, hey. Maybe you can tell these two that this is not the time or place to
This is not the time or the place, you guys.
You certainly are more agreeable than usual today. You think the Admiral is just slacking off? Unthinkable. Echo, you've got it all wrong. This is all for the benefit of the future. What does my marriage with Zeno have to do with the future? Are you sure you don't have some admiral work to be doing? I've pretty much finished everything I need to do in my capacity as admiral. Left is to wait for the final showdown. There's no sense in continuing to flail around at this point. Right now, we have far more important things to consider.
So then, why are you talking to her about her marriage life?
Right now, we have things to consider? Yes, I'm talking about the future. About what happens when everything is finally over and we have peace. We won't be fighting some all-powerful enemy. From here on, we'll be fighting to maintain a peaceful world. So that we don't forget this all-important goal, we must consider what comes after.
So you guys are thinking about getting married if you survive all this?
Come on, Echo. I've never known anything about marriage, and I can't even begin to imagine what it entails. Okay, fine. I doubt I can give you the answers you're looking for, but what do you want to know? Could I ask a question? I've always been really interested. What exactly does it feel like when the person you love
shit.
Well, mutual love is about... It's kind of hard to put into words. You feel at ease. Like you're wrapped in a comfy blanket. You're swaddled in the trust between you and your partner. Before we got married, I was really nervous. I wondered if Zeno would even make it back. I tried to stay positive. But
But when we got married, I started to realize that I have to trust Zeno, and my nervousness completely disappeared.
You're the one that asked. Can you believe this?
It was sweeter than candy.
This is how you treat me for being honest? I shouldn't have said anything. All right, I should probably go and visit Theo before the final showdown. See you later. Yeah, I want to go see how Zeno is doing. See you two later. Hey.
Her horns are all glittery and staticky. I just noticed that. The Dauntless Duo.
Oh, you'll be marching right into the lion's den soon enough, right? Are you all ready?
We'll be deploying as well. We were just heading out now to our strategy session.
Hey! Huey!
Huey!
It's been a while.
It's been a while.
Aren't you supposed to be on Amduskia along with Sarah?
Well, I've got to come back to resupply and report sometime. I'm only here for a bit.
And who are you?
Pleased.
Felig.
My name is Felig Ives. It's nice to meet you. Should be the one apologizing for startling you. I sensed a strong aura gathering in this area and came to see what was going on. No one said it was you.
How are things on your end?
We've already repelled the invaders from Earth. The Mother Corps are currently mopping up, so I imagine things are well under control. That aside, that menacing aura I felt from you. You've really got quite an air about you. It was truly magnificent.
I noticed that you didn't give an inch even when I turned to you. You're clearly no greenhorn.
I am honored by your kind words. Perhaps you would also kindly honor me with a bout of sparring.
You mean a one-on-one fight?
Don't hurt her, Mert. For like.
Duel? You guys are going to have a duel? In that case, I'll join you too.
The Council of Six versus the Fiend. That should really get the blood pumping. Clarice Grace, prepare immediately.
Okay, got it.
Isn't Sarah waiting for us?
That's right. Sorry. The higher ups are calling me too. Leave the sparring for another day.
Well, that's a shame, but you have a point. We can revisit the idea the next time we meet.
We're really not going to do it.
Not right now. All right, let's head out. Come, Clarice Grace.
Me? No, I'm okay, thank you. And I'm gonna call it for this week. Thank you and have a good one.